As an emperor, he should have been married at 15, but things had been delayed. Once married, he would officially become an adult, and Empress Dowager Sa Shi would have to pass imperial power to him. The minister serving at court and the people had urged the Empress Dowager to hand over power to him. However, the Empress Dowager, who was then 53, thought she was in the prime of her political life. As he came of age, she knew that she would have no reason to rule the empire on his behalf anymore. To gain even more influence over him, she took control of his marriage to ensure that the bride would be someone she trusted. Chose to be his wife had often been the result of, as well as the cause of, power struggles in China's history. However, the young emperor seemed oblivious to the power struggle that was going on. His mind was focused on what he could do for the empire after he took office. July 27, 1888, the Empress Dowager issued a decree which stated, "In the first month of next year, the Emperor will marry and take office as desired by all the people under heaven." The young emperor repeated the words in the Empress Dowager's decree. This was the most joyful moment he had for many years. The emperor immediately wrote a letter to the Empress Dowager. He thanked her for her loving care over the years and wished her the best after retirement. He said he would obey her decree and take office the following year. It was a touching letter that expressed his gratitude toward her, as well as his joy at being able to rule the country independently.
Young 他一直是有这个想法，希望尽快自己亲政，希望尽快自己在这个朝廷的这个政务中有所作为，希望自己在历史上留下一片光辉的一页。
At the time, China was threatened by Russia, France, and Great Britain.An ambitious emperor hoped to do something to restore peace and prosperity to China, as what Emperor Kang Xi had done over 200 years ago. According to the emperor's teacher, Wang Tonghe, Emperor Guangxu had studied hard, even when he was ill. Compared with Emperor Tongzhe, he was a much better student. Wang Tonghe taught both Emperor Tongzhe and Emperor Guangxu. He was a traditional Chinese scholar and an idealistic educator.He taught his students to work hard for the welfare of the people and the country. He was a man of great virtue. After working as a top official for 42 years, he had no savings at all. This was perhaps why the Empress Dowager chose him to teach the emperor, since it showed how idealistic and incorruptible he was.
We and he are almost every day can meet the emperor. Teach him to read.在这读书，教他人生的道理、社会的道理、国家的道理，这是亲生父子。
光绪从4岁入宫，6岁点学，就是去上书房读书，就在翁师傅的这个教导之下成长。
Tonghe's teaching and companionship, the emperor grew up to be a young man who cared deeply about the welfare of his people and his country. When he was 15, he wrote a poem expressing his compassion for those suffering in the freezing winter, while those living at the palace enjoyed warmth and comfort.The ninth emperor of the Qing dynasty, the emperor seemed to offer new life to this fading empire. Now grown up, the emperor hoped to take measures to save his empire from the internal and external strife.The Empress Dowager, his foster mother, wanted him to be her puppet. Babies aged between 13 and 17, 5 girls became the final candidates.5th, 1888, the emperor got up early to meet these 5 young ladies. The girls entered the palace. The first one was Jing Fun, Yahen Ala, the daughter of a high-ranking military officer. She was the Empress Dowager's brother's daughter and was 21. The emperor had known her since the two prospective marriage partners had been children. When she had been a little girl, she had often been invited to accompany her aunt, Empress Dowager Cixi. Sometimes, she had also been allowed to play with the emperor. According to the law, she was too old for selection. However, the Empress Dowager wanted to make an exception for her niece. It seems that the Empress Dowager wanted her niece to become the emperor's wife. This would have made the young lady empress of the Qing dynasty. Understood that the Empress Dowager didn't want to relinquish control of his life. Since the moment he had been forced to sit on the royal throne as a child, his life had been in the hands of this woman. Dowager still treated him as her puppet. According to the law, if the emperor chose a girl to be his wife, he had to give her a jade amulet. His future concubines would only receive embroidery amulets.
那么光绪皇帝这拿着如意，啊，走到了这个德馨这个女儿这儿，啊，就是没有给这个慈禧太后那个侄女，啊，就要把这个如意呢给德馨的女儿。这个时候慈禧太后一看，她必须要出面了，啊，所以说大喊了一声：“皇帝！”喊一声，那么这对光绪皇帝这一惊，啊，一怔。
Lost his nerve. He was too weak to disobey the Empress Dowager, the woman who had made him emperor. So, in the end, the emperor chose the empress dowager's niece to be his wife. The empress dowager could tell that the emperor really liked the other girl. She knew that if she became the emperor's concubine, she could be a threat to her niece. So she made the decision on the emperor's behalf to offer the embroidered amulets to the daughters of another official. The empress dowager's niece was later given the title Empress Long Yu, seen here. Both Empress Dowager Cixi and Empress Long Yu have been born into the Yahan Ala family. This is a street in the center of Beijing. Empress Dowager Cixi was born here in 1835. In 1860, she arranged for her sister to marry her husband, Emperor Shi Anfeng's brother. In 1875, she made her nephew emperor. Now she was to arrange for her niece to marry the emperor. These were the type of power games she played so well. Dowager Cixi issued a decree announcing this decision. January 27th, 1889, the emperor's wedding ceremony took place. Was inspired by the love of this beautiful woman. But he didn't know that their relationship might cost him her life and him his power as emperor. Join us for part 4 of Emperor Wangshu.